did it burn you, carries the key, never bash it.
This is just one of many illustrative phrases that Chopin used during lessons with his students. Many of those lessons were conducted by him on this exact Pleyel piano.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the occasion of the 211th anniversary of Chopin's birth, we have prepared a very special concert for you today on the rediscovered Chopin piano made by Pleyel in 1847. Exactly on this piano, Chopin taught his students. This piano has a serial number 13,214. This piano was in Chopin's apartment in Paris at 9 Square d'Orléans from March 1847 to February 1848. Well, what did Chopin do in his salon? How was it exactly with his creative activity? Of course, we all know that he mainly composed, he played some concerts, but Chopin was also a piano teacher. In fact, this piano that was in Chopin's living room helped Chopin as a composer, as a pianist, and as a teacher all the time. We should also add that teaching was his main source of income.
On this instrument, Chopin taught such eminent students as Karol Mikuli, Thomas Tellefsen, Camille Dubois, Maria Alexandrovna von Harder, or Josef Schiffmacher,
as well as Jane Stirling, Adolf Gutmann, Marcelina Czartoryska, Maria Kalergis. All these sat at the keyboard of this instrument and waited for some remarks from Frédéric Chopin. Chopin's apartment in Paris was also a center of many social gatherings and house concerts. On March 23rd, 1847, a musical evening was held in Chopin's apartment in honor of Delfina Potocka, at which Chopin played his just-completed cello sonata in G minor, opus 65, with his friend cellist Auguste Franchon. Among the guests were Anna Czartoryska, Adam Czartoryski, and Chopin's favorite, Georges Sand. This evening was the occasion for the delivery of this piano. Let's start our adventure with Chopin's piano and Chopin's music. Let's listen to the Nocturne in E flat major, opus 9, number 2, by Frédéric Chopin on his piano.
Thank you.
Chopin dedicated his Nocturnes Opus 9 to Marie Pleyel, the wife of Camille Pleyel, who was the owner of the Pleyel piano factory. Pleyel and Chopin shared the love of music, and this led to their lasting cooperation, but not only on artistic level, but also in business. Chopin recommended Pleyel's pianos to his friends, his students, or aristocracy, and in return, he received a 10% commission of each transaction's value. Chopin's authority, of course, improved the sales, and Chopin, on the other hand, had constant access to those instruments. Pleyel had a rival, Erard, and the competition between these two firms reflected the overall rivalry in piano building, in piano trade in Paris. In contrary, Erard entered similar cooperation with another great artist, Franz Liszt. So you can imagine that Chopin's admirers were more likely to buy Pleyel pianos, and fans of Franz Liszt bought Erard. But on the other hand, we know that Chopin and Liszt were close friends, and it is evidenced by Chopin dedicating his Etudes Opus 10 to Franz Liszt. Let's listen to the singing tone of Pleyel once more. Chopin used to say, "When I feel bad, I play a rare piano, and I easily find a good proper tone, sound on it. But when I feel very good and strong enough to find my own sound, I prefer to play Pleyels." Pleyel pianos were perfect for Chopin because it allowed to achieve a lot of different colors, different nuances and shades on the instrument. And these characteristics are very important to Chopin's style, as it was not strictly virtuoso, but more poetic and detailed singing lines. Chopin was the teacher of Charlotte de Rothschild, French painter and art protector. He dedicated his waltz in C-sharp minor, opus 64, number 2, composed on this instrument, to her. Also, the last composition I am going to play for you today, the ballet in F minor, was dedicated to Baroness Charlotte de Rothschild.
Thank you.
Bravo! Tomasz, you are a little exalted, but that's all right. This is what Chopin said to his student Thomas Tellefsen. He used to say, "May you play this note right, don't let it break." Chopin as a teacher was known for his unusual demands and nervousness. His personality was a fusion of precision, patience, determination, and enthusiasm. Whatever his ordinary politeness, even his humor, when he was ill or irritable, was replaced by fits of rage as violent as they were brief. An important Polish student of Chopin was Karol Mikuli. Mikuli was also Chopin's assistant and had the privilege of observing his lessons with other students. The result of these observations and collaboration was Mikuli's publication of Chopin's 14-volume works in 1879 for Kistner in Leipzig. Karol Mikuli, after his long concert career, was linked to Lviv, where he became a main creator of musical life. Also, as an outstanding teacher, he trained a whole generation of great pianists, including Moritz Rosenthal, Aleksander Michałowski, Raul Koczalski. It was Mikuli who gave Teodor Leszetycki important performance advice on Chopin's Nocturne in D-flat major, opus 27. On this basis, Teodor Leszetycki prepared his own version and edition on this Nocturne, which I will play for you. Thank you. This Pleyel was certainly the everyday confidant of Chopin's disappointments and anguish, for it was at this time that a dramatic turn occurred that affected the rest of his short life. The unexpected and extremely violent family conflicts between Sand and her son Maurice on the one hand, and the daughter Solange and her husband Auguste Clésinger, led to a dramatic breakup between Chopin and Sand. This was the end of their relationship, which had lasted for 9 years.
Thank you.
What happened after the breakup with George Sand? Jane Stirling, who has a deep affection for Chopin and was endlessly devoted to him, played an important role. Chopin's appreciation and friendship for Jane was never transformed into true love. Jane Stirling was a pupil of Chopin. She was a Scottish aristocrat with a large fortune. She organized Chopin's concert tour of England and Scotland in 1848. She bought a large part of Chopin's estate, including letters, manuscripts, sketches after his death. She took lessons from Chopin on this piano. She worked with him on his ballad in G minor, opus 23.
Thank you.
I surprise you with a mazurka. Mazurkas are a special mirror of Chopin's Polish soul in his works. This player was used not only for artistic events in the Chopin's home, but also for preparing public performances. I refer here to the famous concert on February 16, 1848, in the Pleyel Hall, which was Chopin's last concert in Paris. He had not performed in public for 6 years, during which long period he became a legend. At the coaxing of his closest friends, finally he decided to give this unique concert. I will play the mazurka in A minor, opus 17, number 4, and mazurka in C major, opus 24, number 2, as well as the famous minute waltz in D flat major, opus 64, number 1. Chopin played these pieces on his last concert in Paris, among others. Chopin also composed this famous minute waltz on this piano.
Bravo! But this is not the end of our concert yet. We still have an encore. It is important to mention German student of Friedrich Chopin, Adolf Gutmann. He belonged to the closest circle of friends, and Chopin dedicated his scherzo in C sharp minor to him. It is known also that Gutmann accompanied Chopin during his last days. We'll play for you Nocturne in A flat major for four hands by Adolf Gutmann. Thank you for sharing this concert with us.
And now, adieu to you all and goodbye.